DVs are just dropping out the end of the barrel. Can we get going? Still not doing anything.
Let's fucking do it.
The rubber will be fine.
That's what I mean. How do you tell when they're worn out?
Right, guys.
Okay, lads.
Well, shoot it today if it starts working again.
Dave, that includes you!
Sorry, madam!
Shut!
Right, ladies and gents. Okay. All right. Yeah, in case you haven't already guessed, or you don't know already, I'm sure. Code 7 Royal Marines. So the stuff that I'm going to teach you now, I know it works. I've had a chance to use it. Colin knows it works. Jason knows it works. So learn from what we say. It does work. Obviously, we've adjusted it slightly for airsoft because we've all been enough times, so we know what's slightly different between the real world and airsoft. So initially, we're just going to go over entering rooms. These rooms here in this building are pretty similar to ones you'll find at Copehill for any of you that haven't been before. So that's why we're using this building. You've got quite big open rooms with a few smaller ones, and then no doors, just big gap. First of all, we're just going to go over the stack. So that's literally how you get into the room, how you get up as a team before you go in the room. So if Colin, Jace, want to start demonstrating the stack. Do you want to just jump in as well?
Jump in.
Yeah, because you've not got down.
Good on.
Right.
They're left-hander on the right-hand side. Oh,
fucking go on. Yeah, you're an awkward shit. I've got you get points. I've got
time,
you've
gone.
Yeah.
Okay, so the stack is literally what you'll do before you go in to a room. What happens? This first man will have his weapon up on aim, waiting for anyone to come out that door. If someone decides to pop their head around, he's going to get them. Not nice. Right. So his weapon's always going to be up. If he needs to talk to someone, he's not going to turn around and go, what, what? He's going to be looking at the threat. That's the threat. If someone comes out there, he's got it. Second man is going to be right behind him, on his shoulder, ready to go in behind him. Second man is always in control of the stack. First man's too busy. All he wants to worry about is this doorway. All the first man wants to worry about is the doorway. Second man is controlling the stack. He's telling the rest of the stack what to do. Third man, or last man in this case, if you're last man, you'll be covering the rear or any other arch you need to cover. Otherwise, you're just if there's a fourth man, you'll obviously just be covering another arc. The last man will be covering the rear. So what happens is they'll be right up against each other on their backs. Weapon can be either by their side, which is a nice one to have, because then if someone comes out, you've still got a shot on. Or you can have it at the top of their back. That way, if they get hit and they go down, you can come straight at the top of them. Or you can have it down by your side, like you see in all the movies. The problem with that is if they get hit, you're going to keep twatting them in the back. You can't get your weapon up. So, personally, I'd go for on the side, on the top. But it's up to you where you want to put it. It doesn't matter that much in the long run. Next stage is going to be the actual room entry. A nice big open space here. This is what we call a long wall because there's no corner there, you can't get in there. That's a good building to have because this doorway is on the side, is on the corner of the room. So you've not got to worry about this corner. The only corner you've got to worry about is that one over there. So that's a bonus. We'll go over centre-fed room in a bit. So first man, his main concern is going to be that next corner because the corner is where people hide. You haven't been in a room when someone's coming at you, chances are you're going to be in the corner or behind a piece of cover. So, and because they don't know what cover's in there, you're going to go straight to the corner. So what's going to happen is the second man who's in control of the stack is going to tell the first man when to go in. What that does is that enables him to know exactly when he's going to go in and he needs to follow right behind him. This is incredibly important. If you're not straight behind your oppo when he goes in there and he gets shut up, you can't cover him. You want to have protection, especially those two corners. You want to go in at the same time as much as possible, so that you can cover each other's backs in case there's one in each corner or one in the opposite corner to the one the first man goes in. Does everyone get that?
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So what's going to happen, the second man is going to either give Cole a squeeze on the arm, and that means go, or he's going to give him a gentle nudge with his leg. Don't belt him, because he will just go down.
He's going to frag it, because we've got like 200.
You want to buy it? Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah.
We're just going to go simple room, aren't you, Fair? Oh. Right. On the squeeze or the nudge, what Kai's going to do is, because we know we don't need to cover this corner, again, that's his threat. So Kai is going to come in, and he's going to quickly check
open
the
right, open front.
Where's your mate going, right, left?
Well, I was going to do it stage by stage. We'll now break that. That's a slight down way. But hey, so Colin,
just got a little bit too professional for me then.
A bit over the top, everyone's a bit keen. Right, I know the building. Colin will come in, he'll pretty much be hugging this corner, and he'll be just stage one. Rich will be right behind him on his back. That way he's going to be straight in behind him. Right, what Colin's doing now is he's literally going to just split second, sorry, can't hear me. Split second, he's going to cover with his eyes this entire area, make sure there's no one there or no cover. If there's an enemy right in front, he can shoot him. But he needs to get them rounds down before he gets that corner because he's going to be going straight in. Don't stop at the door. Never stop at the door. We call it the fatal funnel, and basically that's where everyone's going to be shooting. So you need to get clear of that door as soon as possible. Next stage is going to literally peek round into the corner. Obviously there's a target there.
So he's going to...
That's a plate. He's...
Operator.
That's a plate. He's going to get two rounds to the face or to the chest or whatever, and that's him out of the game. So. What he's doing there is clearing the corner, that's where someone's most likely to hide. That's that, done. He's now going to push along, like I said, straight out that doorway, onto the side. Notice Rich is straight behind him, he's right in there. And then Jace is straight through the middle. There's no gap there for the enemy to have a relapse. There's three lads in there straight away. If you're on your own in a room, and suddenly three blokes come bursting through that door, that's you, Index. Like, you're not going to do anything about that. You might get one if you're lucky. Chances are the first man is going to take a hit. What happens? It happens in real life. Luckily, you got body armor for that. But
hopefully.
So all three blokes are going to be in that room, and hopefully going to overwhelm whoever's in there. You can do this for four people as well, but usually we're going to get three people. What's then going to happen is obviously we still got Jace in the doorway here. So Colin's going to keep pushing on that wall to give Jace enough room to push along that wall as well. And what they'll do is. As they're pushing, you can't see them now, and there's not enough room for you to get in there, but as they're pushing along that wall, they come in the room, and that's the corner. They're bringing their arcs along there, so they're covering the entire room at the same time as moving towards the corner. Don't look into the corner where this target was, because he's gone, he's dead. You don't need to worry about him. So, bang, bang, watch the rest of the room, yeah? Both guys would do that. Jace, however, because the corners have been cleared, unless there was someone in there, and they got his mate, so say Colin got shot, then he'll cover the corner. If Colin's just got someone, Jace can worry about the centre of the room. Rich has come in on the right. Obviously, it's a bit of a difficult one because he's got another doorway there. So, and also it's a long wall. What we generally do is we try not to get him staying in this doorway. Unfortunately, it's quite hard because the second doorway, if you can't see, you might want to come round. The second doorway is halfway along the wall. So what Rich is going to do is he's going to come in, he's going to quickly scan his arcs the rest of the room, but then he's going to cover that doorway because that's his next threat. And effectively, he's now the first man in the next step. So he'll be waiting by that door. Being very careful not to poke his barrel around the corner. That's a massive one that people
see. Is that full wall?
Yeah, for now we'll call it a wall.
Right. Okay.
For the sake of this, we're going to call that a wall over there. So what?
I was looking at a wall.
Yeah. So what Rich would do is he'll call open door right, stack on me. And what then will happen is the next two guys will just stack up behind him, ready to go in. This room's clear now, we don't need to worry about that. The next threat is that doorway. And then at which point, Jace will give the nudge, and then they'll go in together. And kill the target in there. And poor little bloke.
Room clear!
Once you've cleared a room, always shout room clear. Everyone shouts room clear. And if you want, you can shout building clear. Right, if you want to come back outside, we'll go to it all in the water. So you can see here.
That's
real time. Yeah, real time.
Are we taking that as a wall then and just stacking straight?
Yeah, for now,
so that's a wall, so we've only got to worry about the right.
That's going to be a wall that.
Yes, short man way. Over there!
Do you want the camera inside or not?
Sorry?
Do you want your camera inside? So that
yeah, can do.
Yeah.
Do you want my head?
Don't stand by any bits of MDF with shiny things on.
Well, hopefully this demonstration will be perfect.
Right.
Hopefully there'll be no gaps between the guys going in. What we'll do is I'll take the first room first, and then we'll just stop them, and then they'll recut and take the second room. Okay. All right, so in real time.
Go. Stop on me! Red flag! Red flag!
Cut! Nice to see that.
Red flag!
Yeah, it's pretty good.
That's the speed we expect to cope with.
Apart from that, wait for
the
fun.
Yeah. Use the balls. I have done that when you throw it and you go.
We'll go into grenades in 2 seconds.
Just take it in with you. Can you hold that for me?
Just a quick one. When you're outside the room, don't worry too much about being so quick that you're not thinking, right? Give yourself a second to get yourself sorted, make sure you're all ready to go, there's no problems. Make sure your weapon's ready as well. Yeah, it's not fucking easy to do that. And then the real quick bit is getting into that room. Once they're in that room, they can then take 1-2 seconds, just take it all in. Right, room's clear. Everyone shout, room clear, make sure it is clear. We'll go on Spanish in a bit. And then they've got a couple of seconds to recock, get into that, and then they can give themselves another couple of seconds just to think about what they're going to do, and then go in. If you rush too much, you're not going to be thinking, you're just going to get shot up. So take your time, but don't do what everyone tends to do and end up standing around for about 20 minutes before they enter a room. Well, take a room, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, recock, take the next room. Keep blasting through the rooms, don't stop, because that's when the enemy gets a chance to regroup and
Take again. Well, no bones, it takes bollocks to walk into a room at Cope Hill.
One point to note, because everybody does it, including the professionals, when you're first going in, fresh mag, single fire only in the building, so you can count your rounds, count your rounds down, because you get halfway through the building, you think, I've only got 10 rounds left in this mag, swap it.
Yeah.
If you need to change mag,
dead man's
when you're in the building,
for a reason.
Just shout magazine. Take a knee and someone will get over top of you, because obviously if you've not got a mag in, you're useless. So, magazine, get down, next guy will cover you. Right, I'm going to quickly go with grenades and then we'll break them down and let them go.
Let them go for it, yeah.
Where's... Here comes the boom, ready or not, here comes the boys for the sound. I got it.
Got your banger.
Can we throw your bang?
Chef, I've got one with a dodgy lid, you might as well use it before I can set...
We'll use this first. Taking buildings is risky business. Chances are you're going to get shot. So a good way of getting into a room is to use a grenade. This one's an impact one. However, these red ones and other ones you get, they have a bit of a fuse on. So chances are you'll be using one with a fuse.
You've got a little bit of a longer weapon. Always.
We're just sort of.
It's what I'm renowned for.
So I've got a longer weapon. Throw it. It won't go back that way.
It won't go back.
Don't drop it.
I've got a chest load on them. Are we ready?
Yeah, we're just going to go over it first and then and then we'll do it in full time. So show them the motion in the slow time.
But don't do it. Right. So, what was your stack on the door? Stop
second man.
At you.
Second man, the guy in charge, is going to be the one with the grenade. He's going to show the person in front of him.
That's dangerous. Come out that end. Right. Dan Royal was a fucking one of them.
How did this happen? You should know better. Right? So he's going to show first man that he's got a grenade he's going to throw it in. So he's literally, and the guy behind him, so he's literally going to put it in front of his face. He can just give a quick nod so he knows, just so that he's aware that grenades going to go in. As soon as that bang goes off, they're straight in that room. No fucking around, no waiting. No waiting around, just straight in that room after the bang. Go bang in. Yeah. Most rooms at Cope Hill, if we've got them, we're going to use grenades because it's the best way to push the enemy back. And they'll keep running out of that room.
Remember, when the pin is at the grenade, it's no longer your friend.
Guys, just break yourselves down into teams of... No, teams of four. Break yourselves down into teams of... Four, and then we'll step up to four.
Show
do this. All the long ones.
Yeah, all the long gunners.
Let's practice.
Chris, we're those three.
First four, follow Colt.
Alright.
That's the most awkward team in the
world. This is where we practice dragging our barrels along the wall.
No, that's fine. Right. So, to be honest, it's going to be top ball. That's fine. You can't even go see. So stack on this wall. Whoever's going to be the boss, stack on it.
That's
the barrel!
Oh dear, let's have a look.
Which is why we're here.
Is that the barrel or the two free?
It's the barrel. Just your barrel break.
Right, guys. Right. Stack. To be honest, can I make a suggestion? Can you just borrow it to dry drill with?
Yeah.
Put that down. No, not that.
Oh, that. Yeah.
Put that down, put that on. You're not going to do a lot with that coke in the building. Right, again we're going without banks first of all, so there are targets set up in there. And your point this way, it's great doing that. Don't ever travel faster than what you can shoot at. There's no point in sprint unless you've got to sprint across the gap and someone's in covering fire. There's a building, stop it, there, guys, shut them. Okay? You want to be, wherever that barrel is, you want to be. What's the point in doing that and then looking over there? Because if I look through that gap and someone's got a weapon on me, I'm gone. What I want to be doing is I come through, when I open the gap, I don't want to be there. Because if I see them, I want to be slotting them. There's no fucking point in having a head on a swivel that way, or the barrel that way. You're fucking dead. You're gone. Okay? Back out. Go again. Swap it for you.
So now I'll go. So.
When you're ready. You followed him, guys, just look this way, did it? When he went in, you followed him like that. He'd got his barrel across that way and you pointed in his back. If he's running that way, I hope there's not enemy in that corner because he's already dropped him. You'd drop that as soon as you come around the corner. So you need to, there's no point in doing that. You need to learn how to fucking move sideways on, okay? Get slick, get the barrel in the room where it's needed, not in his bottom. And why the fuck are you connected to them? Why, like umbilical brothers? There was this whole room, basically the second and third man, when you go in and the long walls want to go fuck off into the middle of that room. Okay? Happy with that? Go again.
Hang on, they're storming this room.
Fuck, that's loud!
Go on with us in a minute. Yeah?
Fucking hell.
That's gonna deafen people.
Right, Colin.
Cole. What are you doing?
Cole, come here, I need to clear this up.
What?
So he goes in, he goes, which corner does he go to first?
The easiest way, how I would do it, there's no set pattern, but how I would do this is the first thing for you to do is leap around the corner. Fuck me, there's your first target gone. I've already cleared it. With such a big entrance, the other thing I would do for me is I need to get the fuck out of here. I would swing, got you, got the corner. I'd clear that room in fucking two steps and getting in that doorway, okay? Because how you do it is you pop it, you fucking slot in, you come round and you're in. And I swear, this is one of the easiest bastard rooms to clear. This is a piece of piss.
Well, I've not done this for a few years.
You step in, there's a room right, there's a room left. Okay? So that's your easiest, certainly with a long barreled weapon, arc it round and in.
Right, so like.
You lot, literally. Right. But not quite yet.
Yeah,
what you want to do,
fast,
pop the corner. Bang, 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 bang. You're in, okay?
Right, so he goes in, goes along this wall. I go that way.
Fucking punch in. He's then going to, if I was going to take it, I would go that way.
Yeah, that's right.
Because as you swung it, I'm already clear. There's a dodgy area though, the other side of that post. So that's still my danger area. So I'm going to go back to that. They're going to start pouring in into that corner, and they're going to start. What the fuck's in that corner? Shit, there's an opening there. One of us has to stay in that corner and protect the building. The third one, get down the other side of him, because he's already well over to that corner by then.
So as you come in the door, you always go a different direction to the man in front of you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Whoever goes in first is the one with the bomb. Because he's the one with the bollocks that's gone in first, he's the one that selects his call.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
So go straight.
Set.
Go. Too long. No, too long. You were far too fucking long. Yeah. That was a fanny. Okay, yeah, go on, bang. If you notice me, look. Yeah, look, watch.
You still have to go through the door.
He squeezes me. Fucking bang, bang.
Right,
see, I'm in a room.
Whereas I went for this way.
You went like... No.
Okay. Set.
Go.
Clip.
Your call. It was you, like, shouting. Fucking hollering. You'll shout room clear, because when we come out of Coldfield, you'll then get the sexy little call of building clear. Okay. Certainly when they've been struggling for 2 hours to take it, and when it bounds, they don't find the spot, go again. We're basically going on all the way across the room, and then you can don't stop, right, guys, you go on for it. Bang, bang, drop, move, bang, bang.
There's too much hesitation.
Whatever you are, whatever you fucking do, that barrel stays in one place and one place only. The bigger you've done this, it's tough shit, nerves and muscles. Okay? It's got to stay there. The minute you drop your barrel, you'll be slotted. Okay? When you come in, the other one you can do, the chef's not covered, is if you haven't got a little weapon, this is the fucking bonus. Stack that door. Stack. Here's the stack. What I can do is go up. This is completely fucking out of the arm, so it's a new thing that's coming, because I'm realizing all the weapons are short, why don't we do it that way? I'm going to the end slowly. As he goes in, I've just got to bring it down the top, which is much better than me trying to get it up from there. It's always easy to drop it and get it up. That's why they invented the blue pills.
Yeah.
Right, here's another one for you then. This is a bitch. It's back on that side. There's a wall across here. Okay, guys, this is the wall now. That is your room. All right, so there's a wall across here. Okay. So stack on that wall and we'll shift it over. Right, guys, are you ready?
Ready?
Yeah.
All come grinding to a hole and you've got
keep moving, keep moving!
Yeah, don't stop. You won't be able to stop at Coke Mill. But you will, but that's what's annoying. If you stop at Coke Mill, I'll fucking steamroll you. That's all I'm going to do is put me on. If one of you hits at Coke Mill going, guys, put an arm in their back, pushing against the wall. Get the fog past me.
Right, so if you do take a hit, first man in, just...
If you take a hit, first man in.
You've got to move out of the way.
I go fucking hit, and I just go in like that. And I just get the fuck out of the way. You've just got to get the fuck out of the way. You're going to get hit 3 or 4 more times. Yeah. People go, I'm already dead. Stupid. You fucking
it's going to happen.
You know what I mean? If you're going in hard and aggressive, you will shoot more than once.
Let's go this wall because it's right handed.
Oh dear.
I want to try team lead again.
Right, I've not been third person yet, so I'll be third.
Guys, remember this is a fucking quick one because it's an impact, okay? This is why I personally don't like using impact till the last room. I like using fuse. The reason being is it goes in, everyone goes, oh shit, and they all run out to another room. And then you take the room. And then you throw a fuse in that one and they all go, oh shit, and they all run into the next room. And what they do is they end up with 20 of them like that in the last room, and that's the one you impact grenade. And they all go,
no chance for
one grenade. So remember, your reactions with this one have got to be fucking quick, because as soon as this goes bang, you're in, okay?
Change
position
to
do it again or
no?
Okay,
take
one first.
What
you
do,
no,
I'm just
going to
stand inside, don't fucking shoot me.
Are we going in just...
Is this
a wall?
I was going to say, because otherwise, what the fuck just happened? That's good. Your speed and aggression into the room, brilliant, I like that. If you're going to take a corner, like what you're going to do in a bit, you've got three ways you can do it. You've got the high-low method, so initially, you start from the corner. So this is the corner. You start the first man, take a knee around the side, or better yet, around the side that's still got a lot of the body covered by this wall. Go around the side, the next man will lift you in the middle of the top, yeah? The other way is for first man to go long, second man to go short. The first man will go straight across to the long wall. Next man will pop it straight after, so that way you've got two guns out there. The third way, especially if you've got a small corridor, is just literally the first man pop and just stay there, cover the entire hallway. You can then shout back. But we've got a doorway on the right, fucking. That's it, yeah, whatever.
We're assuming that from here to that pillar is a wall, and then it's open from there. We're stacking up on this wall, we're going to clear this room first, and then there's a corridor right at the pillar.
Okay.
So we're going to try and sweep round the pillar and then clear the next room. Okay. Keep going along.
Stack on me!
Stack! Fucking hell. How are we doing this? Right.
Hold on, mate.
We happy with that? I mean, there was nothing to shoot at, but you get the idea. Haggis Platoon's going to shit themselves when I send them all this video.
We clear this room and the next room. We leave three enemy in there. When you hit them, they will say they're dead. When they hit you, just carry on normal jogging. Right, guys! Game on! Guys, fuck them off, okay? Door in front! Door in right! Why don't we take him out? Enemy in that room there! Right, well, if there's enemy, how are you going to do it? Stack the fuck up on the building. Go on, get in there. Stack on me if you want to say it. If
you're not, across
don't worry about it. But I wouldn't move across an open gap.
No,
you
no.
Stack on your own there. Right, join in the fun frolics when you can. That's how it's ended up. It doesn't matter. Get the fucking barrel up.
Get the barrel up! Rah!
Well, what's in the
back? Get the barrel up!
Remember, you and all your hits. Get them. Go on, get them aggression. Stack up and never fuck it. There's nothing to shoot here. No, don't take your hits. Shoot them back. They'll take their hits.
Hit.
They'll take their hits. You won't have to.
Stack up. Do something. Get the fuck in there. Get in there. Get in there. Get in there. Go on, push it. Push it. Push it.
I tell you what. Right, my lot, stack. Pricey, go. Yeah, Pricey, wait. Stack.
That's it, go!
Yeah, fucking stack. Right, ready? This is aggression, because they fucking stopped in every single doorway going. Alright? Go for it. This room and the next room. Do it. Don't be stack on the right. Ready, stack on me. Don't stay there. Ready?
One, two, three.
Nice pair of hat calls.
Oh, fucking middle of the room is here. Sorry, can you be on for like 5 seconds?
You did.
Students take note, eh?
How did you get a what? I have to remember that. Zombie game. You've got the two buildings, this one and that one. We can get in there, human. This one or the next one. When you're dead, we're gonna
I'm a kill!
Go for it! You've got like 30 seconds and we're all going to disappear to the other side of the building. Quick,
hide! Right, I'm going to disappear. Game on!
Hold on the right.
I'm watching left. You guys watch right. I can't see right. Too much shrubbery. Another one in the ocean. That's on me. Feel bad for shooting that guy. Just stood there.
Oh, hit! Get in there, go on, push it, get out of the door.